San Diego Gas and Electric's Palomar Energy Center in Escondido is a state-of-the-art facility. The 550-megawatt natural gas-fired power plant generates enough electricity to power 360,000 homes. Pollutants are scrubbed down of the plant's exhaust, but carbon dioxide still gets into the air because natural gas is burned to create electricity. That puts pressure on energy companies who are under a legislative pressure to shrink their carbon footprint.
Starting in 2015, gas companies also will have a carbon limit imposed, a carbon cap.
Jeff Reed is in charge of emerging technologies at Southern California Gas Company, which sells natural gas to this power plant.
So gas companies also need to start looking at sources of renewable natural gas, and I think we're ahead of the curve.
Getting ahead of the legislatively created curve means looking at two things: cleaning carbon out of power plant smokestacks and using clean, low-carbon fuel. Algae has the potential to do both at gas-fired power plants.
The tops of those stacks, instead of just going out to the atmosphere after the scrubbing that already happens, they would just be turned over and they would effectively bubble through a very large algae pond.
The carbon dioxide would feed the algae, which could be harvested, fermented, and turned into methane. Methane is linked to global warming, but it releases less carbon dioxide than natural gas when burned. The technology is just a concept right now, but researchers at the Scripps Institution of Oceanography are trying to figure out if it will work in real life.
So this bottle of carbon dioxide gas is fed into this apparatus, which is then fed into the tubes. And then we can set the pH at different levels that might be found in nature.
Dominic Mendola is working on a two-year project to see if the algae carbon trap will work out.
Algae are plants. They happen to be, submerged plants. But we can put CO2 into the water by bubbling CO2 into an algal culture raceway, for example, or into a photobioreactor. You put bubbles in of CO2, and then you tune it to the right rate of emission of the CO2 to the growth of the algae in that system and in that environment.
Mendola is working with different algal strains and different levels of CO2. He hopes to be able to pinpoint the most efficient blend and find out if the idea is practical. He sees it as a way to give back.
If man has had some contribution to putting extra CO2 into the atmosphere, then man has a moral responsibility to help do something about it. So in this laboratory, we're studying how algae can absorb CO2 from the atmosphere.
But the concept carries a price tag. A power plant like the one in Escondido would need a major retrofit and land nearby to build enough algae ponds to filter the plant's emissions. Land costs money, especially in Southern California.
You can't do this for free. It has to pay for itself, or at least come close to paying for itself. And the way you do that is by letting the algae convert the CO2 into useful biomass.
That biomass can be diesel, methane, or even high-protein animal feed. All can be sold to help pay for the retrofit. Scientists hope to know a lot more about the idea's potential when the two-year project is complete.